Integrated Pest Management, or IPM, is a simple ongoing system of pest management that focuses mainly on prevention. Along with prevention, IPM incorporates other types of control, such as cultural, mechanical, biological, and chemical control. The nice thing about IPM is it includes steps that are repeatable and effective for all pests. Why use IPM? IPM can make pest control more effective, safer for students and other building occupants. Over time, the efficiencies of an IPM program can also save schools money. IPM works for all pests in all situations. The steps to IPM that work for schools and other facilities include pest identification, pest prevention, monitoring, choosing your options, action, and evaluation. Depending on the specific pest you're dealing with, some steps will be more important than others. In the case of mouse control, identification of deer mice is important because they can be carriers of hantavirus. Since mice can cause disease and trigger asthma, the presence of a single mouse in a school usually means that pest control action is needed. Prevention of mouse problems includes three main areas: excluding them in the first place, sanitation, and reducing clutter. Exclusion includes making sure door sweeps make full contact and there's no gaps at the end, and sealing holes around foundations. Sanitation limits food and water supply for mice by making sure food items are sealed in containers. Eliminate mouse shelter by cleaning up clutter that gives mice a place to hide or nest. Monitoring for signs of mouse activity, such as droppings or chewed up material, can lead to a quick response to controlling mice. When monitoring for mice, a UV blacklight is a handy tool to illuminate mice urine trails. If control is necessary and trapping is the option chosen, place traps in the area where the mouse activity is the most apparent. 6 traps per mouse or problem area is better than fewer traps. Double traps can be more effective and also help determine which direction the mice are coming from. There are 5 other key components of IPM, such as maps, record keeping, thresholds, notification, and education. These other components are covered in more detail on the Wyoming School IPM website. Hopefully, we've helped you understand that IPM has the potential to prevent and manage pest problems in your facility. For more information and additional help implementing IPM, contact the Wyoming School IPM program.